Hey everybody, welcome back to episode 2 of Inside the Track. Today we're going to jump into Like a Stone by Audioslave. This is a track I recorded last summer with the lovely Philip Joyce and Carlos from Greece. I can't pronounce the second name. It's Spiridion Padidos. I'm sorry, I'll put the link in the description, but fantastic drummer from Greece I met online on YouTube. So without further ado, let's jump into the track. So to kick off, I'm just going to go through the channel list really quickly. The drums are a stereo bounce that Carlos pretty much mixed himself. I just brought them in, so they're basically on a stereo track. Then I have some of the bass, the guitar, and then vocals. So we'll go through them and see what's happening inside this. So let's kick off with the drums. So as I said, the drums are really just a stereo bounce. That sound like this. I just added a little bit of low end to the kick. So this is without my EQ. My EQ. You just hear a little bit of a thud on the low end, but that's basically his drums. So bring in the bass to myself. So I usually split the bass up into two different components, a high and a low. So let's listen to the first section. This is my cleaner signal, just DI with a bit of a bass boost. By the way, this was recorded a long time before the Muse track, and I was still learning, so this is still, this session wouldn't be as good as maybe as the other ones I would have, in my opinion, would have mixed. So bear with me on this one. So yeah, so this is the bass DI, and then I have a dirty deep bass as well. More high end. I have the CLA bass on this one. Just doing a little bit of compression, a little bit of chorus, taking out some of the lower end as I usually do and adding it back in then with the second track. Then on the bass bus, I have a little bit of compression. Take off the highs. It's getting compressed quite a bit there, 6 dB of compression. And then together with the drums. Ah, yeah. So the bass was recorded on a Fender Squire. I know, believe that. Going straight into the Universal Audio Sans Amp. The Universal Audio Ampeg Virtual Amp Simulator, which is in the Apollo Twin. So that is what the bass signal is straight in. And then I'm doing a little bit of processing here, as you can see inside. So nothing too crazy. So then if you move across, we'll come to the main guitar hook, which really is just a combination of a tremolo and a simple, very simple guitar part. So this is what it sounds like. And then if you add in the tremolo, two. So the tremolo is being got from my I should have gone through my effects as well at the start. Rushed this one a little bit. So my effect chain is a flange. My flange channel consists of a vibrato and a phaser. So that's what's giving us that wobble sound there. I'm sending that to this. I have both the phaser and the tremolo on that input. That's what we're hearing there. Then I have a little bit of chorus, a little bit of modulation for a bit of widening and thickening, reverb, more reverb, and more reverb. As I said, I usually have a small, a medium, and a large reverbs. Sorry, I should have gone through the effects at the start, but there you go. Very, very, very simple. So that's the main hook and together in the mix. Sorry, and then the EQ here, not much going on. I'm not even rolling off any low end, surprisingly enough, which is strange. Probably wanted to make it fatter. I've inserted the little bit of delay on the channel, so let's see what it sounds like with and without. Without. With. Very tight slap. Reverb. Again, so I was starting to really learn how to mix here at this stage, so I was just inserting things on the channel. It wasn't really was just experimenting, so that's sometimes the best way to do it. So let's have a listen in the mix. Yeah, groovy. So I'll come back to the vocals at the end, but let's just jump across here into the first. That's basically the first verse, and then the chorus enters like this on the guitars. So as you can see, I have two pairs of guitars here. So let's listen to these in isolation. This is the first pair. Hard left, hard right. You can also hear them going to the tremolo. So without the tremolo. Adding tremolo in. And the next pair has no tremolo and just another pair of guitars. So let's just check this out. No EQ. Get the sound right at the source. Nice wall of guitars. Hard left, hard right. In the mix. That's basically it. That's the two pairs of guitars, one going to the same tremolo scent, tremolo effect, and then the other is just dry, and left and right, two pairs. That's it. This is a very simple track. I forgot how simple this is. Second verse again is the same. You can hear it here. Okay, and then we move along to the amazing guitar solo, which is probably my favorite part of the song. This was done by the amazing Philip Joyce from the amazing Irish band Bluemoose. One of my favorite guys to go see play live, probably the best live band, one of the best live bands I've ever seen. So this is by the amazing Philip, who also does a little bit of singing on this, which we'll get to in this vocal section. So this is the guitar solo. Let's listen to this in the mix first. Oh man, wow. When Philip sent me on these tracks, I was like, wow, oh, man, that's so good. It's the nice little touch at the end, that super fast legato type run he's doing, putting his own stamp on it. Off Philip, absolutely amazing. So let's listen to that and break this down a little bit in isolation. So I'll just take off the effects I have on it, and we'll just see. This is what Philip sent me raw. Almost perfect tone, basically perfect. You can hear the expressiveness there when he's playing there. Just a little bit of delay on the phrasing of that bend. It's just fucking brilliant. Well done, man. That's brilliant. So basically, let's just play this again. I'll just add in the EQ I've added in. So just the EQ, so I'm just adding a little bit of high end, taking out a little bit of low mid, so without, within, so you can hear it's brightening it up a little bit. Again, Philip dialed in the tone perfectly, so it made my life super easy. Tiny bit of, in around 3.5k, little bit of 8k, that's it. And then I add in a little bit of delay, just to give, because Philip has all the space. The production of this song is so simple that there's so much space here for the solo with the delays and reverb. So I just made his solo sound a little bit wider with a little bit of delay. So I play with this and I'll bring in the delay. Bring in the delay. Hear there. So here's my delay settings. Ping pong, 117 on one side, 136 on the other side, a little bit of modulation as well. Taking out some of the low end. And then I'll bring in the reverb. So let's say listen to the reverb coming in too. Reverb in. 20 second pre-delay. Mid-second. Wait for the run, wait for the run. Oh, yes. That is how you do it. Let's listen to that last run in the mix. Pwah. Then we're into the bridge section. So Philip sings in this part here with me. So we'll come to that now in the vocals. So this is the acoustic guitar that I threw down left and right for the bridge section. Very simple. A little bit of EQ on the acoustic guitar. Taking out some low end, adding a little bit of high end. So that's what this is. What this sounds like. A little bit of effects, CLA on the track. Dry. Usually I EQ the acoustic guitars a little bit different on each side, so they sound a little bit different, so it adds more width to the sound. And then I've, again, inserting, there's no problem inserting effects on the track. I don't really do it too much anymore, but I do it on bus then sometimes. But again, just inserting a little bit of what looks like reverb, really, a little bit of compression, a bit of EQ. So let's bring in these effects. And in the mix. Super simple here, this song. So that's the acoustic guitars. Again, on the outro, just the same guitars, double tracked, two pairs, and that's it. So let's jump back into the first verse. So again, on these vocals, very simple. I was starting off mixing. I have a little bit of tuning for my own voice. Not Chris Cornell at all. It was extremely difficult to sing this song. So I do have a little bit of tuning in my voice to keep my keep myself honest, but I'll play with and without. So this is the EQ on my vocal. Whoops. Might have fucking unmuted. Let's just mute this guitar too. Okay. Okay, so let's jump into the vocals. So I am not Chris Cornell at all in any shape or any form. So I do have a little tiny bit of tuning on my vocals just to help me out, to keep myself honest on this one. But I'll play it with and without, and then a little bit of EQ and a little bit of reverb. Really, that's it. So let's listen to the vocals.
And on my deathbed.
So you can see I'm just low filter, tiny bit of high, 10K, a little bit of presence, a little bit of 1K, a little bit of low end to beef it up. I'm not even compressing on this, which is unusual. Usually I would compress over here, but I'm not. So this is with it in.
On my deathbed,
so tuning off.
Pray to the gods and the angels,
and
like a pagan.
As you can see.
To anyone who will take me.
Very subtle.
To anyone who will take me to heaven, to a place I recall.
Then the CLA, just doing its thing, a little bit of EQ, bit of compression, that's basically it, and then in the track.
To anyone who will take me to heaven, to a place.
And the chorus vocals then, I have double, triple tracked. So this is the first one, with a little bit of distortion on the vocal. Here's the harmonies. Main vocal.
Patiently I wait for you there.
Tuning off.
Like a stone I wait for you there. Alone.
So there you go. Not too much, to the tiniest bit of little tuning on the vocals, and then lower harmony, and then lots of the delay and reverb, so you can hear that coming in. So then in the mix, it sounds like this. I remember this part here in the vocal is so hard to get this correct, but I think I kind of got it in and around there. So that's most of my vocals, and then if you jump across to the lovely Philip. Phil's got such an amazing voice. Here we go. Philip has no tuning on his vocals whatsoever. Just saying. Usually I don't tune my vocals too much, but Philip has none. He's an amazing singer.
And on I read until the day.
And then dry.
And on I read until the day was gone, and I sat in regret.
So you can see a little bit of high end again, not too much. Not so much, really. You know, it's, if you get a good sound at the source, shouldn't have to do much. That's the whole point. Good gear. That's why you can tell your girlfriend and your wife you're buying gear, because you need it to make this happen. See, I'm not doing anything really here. It's just Phil. It's just Phil.
And on I read.
A little bit of compression.
Until the day
a bit of delay.
Was gone and I said.
A bit of reverb.
And regret.
You can see my sounds here. A little bit. That's inserted.
For all that,
so here we have some lovely harmonies coming in. So let me show you what this sounds like together. Again, Phil recorded all these. I think he lives in Galway. Do you, Phil? Let us know in the comments. I think he's a Galway man. Might be wrong there, but so you can hear all the vocals together.
For all that I,
oh, I did tune you a tiny bit, Phil. Here, give me that.
For all that I've blessed and all
in the mix
that I've wronged in dreams.
Actually, before I do that, listen to this run, this vocal run at the end of this. Killer.
My death, I will wander on.
Oh, yeah, let's listen to that again.
Death, I will wander on.
Ah, can't wait to go see Bluemoose again. Here we go in the mix.
In dreams until my death, I will wander around in your house. I long
back to myself.
To be room by.
So I've a few little harmonies here underneath my own vocal. So we can isolate them.
In your house, I long to be room by room. Patiently, I'll wait for you there.
A little bit flat in those last two notes, but it's rock and roll, kids. That's what it's all about. It's not about being perfect. It's about keeping the groove real, keeping the sounding authentic. Even though there was a tiny bit of cheating on that, but you know what I mean? You can fucking correct everything. That's not supposed, the way it's supposed to be. See, this is the beauty about rock music. You can hear where, and the last track, you can hear where it's not perfect, and it's not supposed to be perfect. That's how I like to mix music. That's how I like to make music. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you, especially thank you to Phil and to Carlos for lending me their amazing talents to make this video and make this song possible. So that's it. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you would have done anything differently in the comments, any feedback, any other songs you want me to go through. Always been a massive fan of Chris Cornell, and this was a dream song to play and cover, and I'm a massive Soundgarden fan, massive Audioslave fan, massive Bluemoose fan as well. So thank you everybody for taking part in this, and until next time.